All right, this is your boy T, and y'all are now tuning in to the Problematic Podcast for the best bad advice on the planet.
Mr. Riff Raff, Dale D'Antoni, the Pastel Prince, and you're listening to The Problem Attic, the worst advice show ever. Dan Shreen.
Season 2, let's go. Hey.
Wow. What do you think, guys? What do you think, gals? What is gals? Where does that come from? Girls, gals, you had to have a weird accent to mess up that bad. Well, you know, I go out, get my gals. Oh, you gals. Oh, it's British. It's for the British. Right away, gals. Right this way. Mate of mine, last name Ripper, first name Jack. He said I'm up to get murdered. Ooh, 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 ooh. Can we solve that crime already? Is there a colder case than the Jack the Ripper one? Why don't we take that lady from the show, Cold Case? Hey, Cold Case, I got a cold one for you. Oh, I'm sorry. Too cold? Dude, cold for your liking? They were still murdered, god damn it! So, RIP to those gals. Gals! I'm seeing that it was a horrible mistake for me to make the intro this long because I can do whatever I want. I'm so sorry. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I am so sorry, dude. Before, it was like, I'm going to let you in like a little peek behind the curtain. It was like 3 minutes long. So at least I had to be a little bit hinged. I had to be partly hinged. But I'm letting you know, season two, it is loose. Oh, Jesus. Song rules though, huh? Pretty good? Man, dude. All right, so first I want to just address the release schedule and what's going on with that. So I'm doing every other week. All right, and that's something I can stick to. And then, you know, I don't have to sacrifice the quality. And I'm able to do whatever I want creative-wise. You'll see during this episode, there's a couple different segments. You'll see what I mean. So I'm not asking for approval. I'm letting you know. It's going to be every other week. And the video of the podcast will be released the week after the audio of the podcast is released. Right? So there will be something you can consume every week, I guess. Or, here's the thing. If there's a groundswell, if there's a calling that people want me to do Patreon shit, I will. Maybe you want me to review songs. I was thinking about this. Maybe you guys make me review ice cream. You know, put a gun to my head and be like, you have to review ice cream. I don't know. Also, during this episode, there is a part that got cut out due to me being a small, tiny little bitch boy. All right, I'm going through a breakup and I don't know if you knew that. Surprise. Are we all perfect? The answer is yes. To the Lord. Let's go. Hey. Sorry. No, it's just, it seemed a little bit too soon to release that out there. I didn't want to, there's other people involved. You know, they haven't listened to it. I don't want to just speak for them. So I don't want to make it sound like I am polyamorous. When I say they, I mean one person. There's not a group of gals that's, you know, almost slobbing the knob. What would I say that? I didn't say it. Could have just not said it like I did. Anyway, I'm doing the merch release same time this release, at least the first run. And I'm actually proud of it. So, speaking of being proud, you know what else I'm proud of? This episode. Please enjoy Mr. George!
What is your face like in life while you're doing that? Are you physically frowning? No.
Nah, probably not. I'm probably looking up at like, fuck, what should I say?
Yeah, dude. Yeah. Nobody ever, well, physically frowning is.
Yeah.
I mean, they say it takes more muscles to frown than to smile.
I don't know. I've never met they.
I mean, have you ever actually frowned? Make your mouth go.
Yeah. Or mad someone's heart. Told me that I was frowning, even though I was frowning. I had like a sourpuss. Like,
try. Oh, that's good. You did it.
Yeah.
You did
and
it.
They're like, George, what's wrong? I was like, nothing.
I guess I was going through it.
I have no idea. Now, man.
Jesus Christ. Man, dude. The Giants this year. They're so bad.
So you're autistic, though, right?
I don't know. I think I'm good at painting.
I think anybody who likes sports as much as you do has some form of autism.
Oh, I think artistic.
Yeah. No, not artistic. Autism.
Nice.
You got to be on a spectrum.
Nice.
To know stats and numbers. And be like,
yeah.
Oh, you see that first round draft pick on who? I don't have no idea.
Damn,
I
have no idea. Wait.
Like I can't even improv. That's how little I give a fuck
of
about
a team?
It. Dude. No, yeah. I don't
name a team.
Which team? Which sport?
No. Any team.
Any team. Fucking the Cowboys. Okay. The New York Giants. The Jets. The Browns. I know fucking teams. Right. The Spurs. The Bulls. The fucking, you know.
I know you did.
I know all the teams.
Yeah.
I know some of the players have been there a minute.
Yeah.
But other than that, I could not give a fuck about, oh, dude, they got this new rookie. Who the fuck is that? I have no idea who that is.
Yeah. I used to do a thing where I'd like have people ask me. Like, ask me a player and I'll tell you where they went to school.
Yeah, shit like
Jersey
that.
Jersey number.
Yeah.
Usually height and weight.
Crazy, dude.
Like, give me a guy right now.
Bo Jackson,
Auburn.
Uh-huh.
Ooh, what was Bo Jackson like? I'm going to say 6'2", 230.
Mm-hmm.
Probably.
You're right.
Yep, I am right.
I believe you.
There we go.
Yeah.
Can't look it up. That's the best decision I ever made with this podcast.
Is what?
The no looking up.
Oh, no looking up. Yeah. Yeah.
Bogs it down.
It's a lot of work.
Yeah.
You need a guy for that.
Are we on? Yeah. It's just live. But okay. I mean, they'll probably cut this out.
What? It's good banter, bro.
It's good. It's proper banter.
Am I coming in clear?
Do yeah, you're coming in am I mad good? Clear, dude.
Can I come back here?
Too far? You can come, yeah.
Come a little closer?
Don't
move it?
No, I'm playing. It's good. That's the best thing about this.
Yeah.
You're like, it doesn't. Really, people are like, why does it sound so good? And I'm like, well, you know, you tinker with it, but yeah, it's I'm just this.
I'm used to high quality, dude. I don't know what this is about, dude. Nice.
How about that?
Yeah.
You don't see that going on a lot of places.
Well, yeah, well, we got it over there, but yeah, that's cool.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, the pod, do you want to show the merch?
Sure, let's do the merch.
Look at that. Is that a tumbler?
Sure. What is that?
It's that glass, I believe.
A coffee mug? A yeah. thermos?
Yeah. It's there not a thermos.
It's not a thermos?
I don't know.
It keeps my shit warm if it's hot.
You drink soup in it?
Fair point. Touche.
Do you thermos?
I guess I could.
You could.
Yeah, I wouldn't.
Favorite soup, go.
Tomato basil. I'm a basic bitch, dude. Basic bitch.
Oh, that bagel bite soup.
Yeah. With the little bruschetta thing in there.
Oh, no. You know what that's saying? Not basic.
No?
No, that bruschetta.
Oh, bruschetta.
You got that
tomato.
You got that papa, that most hearty.
That's my favorite racial shit.
Oh, yeah.
No one, No one gets in trouble for an Italian accent, dude.
Oh, yeah. And no, I'm told that the voicemail is targeting the Italians.
Really?
And, yeah. The Spanish or the French, I believe. I don't know. It should be. It should be. I don't want to be responsible for Italian hatred.
Of course, you're not.
But, I mean.
You're bringing it to the forefront, actually.
I think there's a lot of people maybe didn't hate him, but now that I'm bringing it up, they're like, it's a good point.
Just a little bit.
I lose my own head. I can't find my head. I go about the.
You know who I can't stand? People from Brooklyn that say, hey, I'm Italian. Oh, what part Italy from? Well, my grandpa was from. You're fucking American, you dumb fuck. Stop talking like that.
Jesus, you know how I do. Guys like me, I go out here, I go back to the boot.
Forget about it.
Yeah. And it's like, dude, you're.
But I can't stand it.
You're white trash.
I can't stand
those guys. Those guys are white trash.
They have to be. Right?
That's next level shit.
Dude. Yeah. They have to be.
Just because they're the
rednecks of.
Yes.
Italy, I guess. I don't fucking
know. Oh, dude, can you imagine how much real Italian people fucking hate Guidos?
Yeah. Africans, black people.
Yep, facts.
Mexicans, and whatever the fuck I am, you know?
Yeah, Moroccan, I learned.
A little bish.
Oh, nice.
A little bish.
But it does make sense. You do seem...
foreign?
Definitely.
Seem, or I look?
You look.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, big difference.
Yeah, bro.
You don't act... You know, like,
sometimes I do.
Do you wear decorative, you don't wear jewelry, so.
Nah, I don't wear jewelry. That's for fucking.
Foreigners.
Weirdos, dude. If you're a dude, like this Gucci Mane book, I could never do shit like this.
Oh, show the cover. Let me see. That's tasteful.
No.
I mean, compared to Kodak right here.
I could never do that.
I mean, it's literally 9 rings.
That's a costume to me, bro. Like, that's just weird. I could never do a bunch of jewelry. If I ever, you know. Win the lottery or fucking rob somebody with a lot of money. I could never have. It's just to me. to me, that's just like, I don't know. You can't be flashy. I don't know. I'm like, it's like a gangster mentality. Like, what are you going to buy the fucking flashiest car on the fucking, I don't know.
Oh, just, yeah.
Like, to me, like you're making yourself a target. That's why I could never be a fucking, a thug, you know? A thug has the fucking flag, you know, wearing the flag and shit.
Yeah.
They got to color coordinate with other, you know.
Oh, it's a lot of work.
Like, what are you doing? Dude. You want to be fucked with? You want to be fucked with?
Yeah. Oh, I was thinking about that.
Crazy
too.
To me, dude.
How about this? As a PSA, if you're a guy out there and you're selling dope, right? In your car, you're driving around, wheeling, dealing. Here's a pro tip. Put on a fucking suit.
Yeah.
Put on a suit.
I agree.
I mean, you'll, and then you get pulled over, and you could just for 1 second be like, oh, yeah, I was on the way to homeless people to help them out.
I just got
to
have a meeting.
I was on a call. How this hard guy is that? Won't pick up the phone. I'm on a call.
Yeah.
He won't pick it up. Like the small things that you could do.
You got to hide shit. Like, be cool. You know, I'm old school. I'm old school.
Like 88, baby.
I don't know. I always believed in like, dude, chill the fuck out. Play low key. Be humble. You know, all this flashy bullshit. It's just, you're putting a target on your back. You know, you can't walk through a certain neighborhood with fucking fresh J's.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're going to get beat up. Wear that shit where you're supposed to go. To the mall. Out, you know.
Yeah. Oh, the mall's big. Yep. Well, also, people don't really, I feel like people don't really kill people for shoes as much anymore.
No, yeah.
Which, I mean, let's bring it back.
Let's bring it back, dude. Yeah.
You know, bring it back.
Whose shoes would you think someone would get killed for nowadays?
Probably Yeezys, I guess.
Yeezys?
Yeah.
Shit. They gotta be... I love art, homie. Take them off.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I like flotation devices on my fucking feet, homie.
Oh, dude.
Get them off.
There's a guy who, like, doesn't really know that much about shoes. But so they're, like, Team Jordans. Okay. He's a guy with Team Jordans.
Oh, that's brutal.
Yeah, he kills a guy for some Team Jordans.
That's brutal, son.
They're always on the shelves. You can always get them.
Yeah, that sucks. That would fucking suck, dude.
$2 for $89.
Because two guys... are embarrassed. The guy that got killed for his team Jordans.
Oh,
and the guy that, well, the guy that mainly got killed was like, yo, they're practice shoes. What the fuck, bro? I'm going to wear my actual shoes to go ball? Yeah. No, I'm going to wear the team Jordans.
He's even, he's like, you can take them. It's fine. You can take
them. Dude, bro, do you don't even have to kill me, dude. Nah. That would suck.
Oh, yeah.
The guy going to jail. I don't regret killing him. I regret stealing the Jordans off his feet.
Ooh, that's egg on my face.
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you ever been to jail?
No, never.
Nice, smart. Me neither.
I've been arrested. I've never been in jail though.
Oh, yeah. I've been detained.
Detained.
But so arrested meaning you went to the.
Yeah, I got booked.
Oh wow!
I was a kid though. Yeah.
Oh okay.
Yeah, I was a kid.
Nice.
Yeah.
What'd you do? Do you want to talk about it?
I just got into a fight.
Oh.
Yeah. So that was it.
I don't think you could do that anymore for sure. Definitely. Yeah. Yeah, you can. Do you think these kids fight?
Yeah, of course, dude.
I don't know.
I mean, it's probably MMA style type shit.
Yeah.
Like a lot of these kids like, oh, I'm in this Krav Maga class, and, you know, or, oh, I take mixed martial arts on the side, you know. But back then, it was just two sissies fighting. Like, I didn't know how to fight. I'm doing windmill, all kind of shit, bro.
Oh, man.
I had to get beat up a couple of times to learn how to fight, you know.
Facts.
But,
yeah.
Yeah, man. Yeah. It's not that, I mean, I was a kid, so I went to juvenile. So it wasn't like scary for me.
That is jail.
Nah, it's not jail.
Like boot camp? Boot camp is not even close, bro.
Okay. Boot camp is not jail. Boot camp is one in, I've heard, my friends went to the bridge. I guess they call it the bridge or the TC.
JJAP?
Some shit. Like, it's always like a fucking three-letter shit.
Yeah.
And they're like, it fucking, oh, Edward, I think, went to boot camp. And
yeah.
Edward was like, it fucking sucks because you're getting cussed out. You're getting fucked with. And these motherfuckers want you to go back to jail because that's how the business is, you know?
Damn.
So if you can make it out of there, and motherfuckers are getting so mad that they fight each other and they go back to fucking prison or they go back to jail and shit, you know? But that's their goal, is to push you out of there. Now, when I was a kid, went to juvenile, they're just like, ah, these are just fucking punks, you know?
Yeah.
I was a cool guy. Yeah.
Wait a minute. If you're only listening, there was a goatee.
I was a cool guy.
Stroke.
So I wasn't like scared or anything, you know. I was a kid. I was like 15 years old. I wasn't scared. I had to go to Scared Straight. Did I tell you about that?
Actual Scared Straight?
Actual Scared Straight.
From TV, or it wasn't on TV?
It was out on TV, and that was part of my probation. I wasn't, like, taped, televised, but I had to go through the program.
What?
Apparently, a lot of people had to go through the program. My buddy, I don't think you ever met him, Sam Shimamura, had to go through it. Edward was, you know, part of their program. He had to fucking talk shit to kids.
No way! Yeah, I would love that.
Yeah, yeah. It was, I guess I was, like, funny back then, because I had to go through that, and I'm sitting there, and it was fucking hilarious, bro.
Yeah.
Like, when you think about, I was thinking about, my God, these are grown men here, sitting here, yelling at children. It was fucking, it was great, bro. It was, we all, okay, so juvenile, right? So juvenile is not a thing. I saw friends I knew in there. It was not scary, bro, at all.
Yeah.
All the fucking, you're getting raped in juvenile, you know, in prison. You know, even Edward will tell you that people who like to fuck men, they meet in there and they do what they do. In the children's prison,
yeah,
it's not like that at all. You're constantly being supervised and watched. You might get into a fight, but that's about it. You know, there's no like real danger and shit. These kids go crazy being locked up in their cells. They do shit. But if you're a good kid like I was, they put you on laundry duty and you're folding laundry while everybody's in their fucking cell. And you got the homies going, hey, bro, like, give me some good boxers, bro. I'm like, dope, give me a cookie when I fucking, when I need one, you know? And so I would get cookies and shit during lunch. It's a little kid shit. They had school in there, which was like fucking, it was crazy because it was like fifth grade shit. And I was 15 years old. And these kids in there were like, hey, what do you got for numbers? Like, there's kids with, you know. Oh,
man. That's
like
tough.
Disabilities in there. So it's really fucking sad. You get to play basketball. They take you to PE.
Oh, it's gross. I mean.
Yeah. Everybody wears Chuck Taylors. It's fucking hilarious, dude.
Dude. And the kids just reading out. And then.
And it separates.
Oh,
the fucking Mexicans.
Yeah.
And then the white guy. There's only one white guy.
Oh, nice.
And then the black dudes, you know?
Yeah.
And then it's a subcategories. This guy's a Crip. This guy's a Blood. This guy's claiming he's fucking with Latin Kings or whatever the fuck, you know?
Nice. It's just organization,
and
really.
I would punch anybody in the face. I didn't give a fuck if you were, you know, whatever gang you thought you were with and shit.
Yeah.
You know? So I was a cool guy. I remember this one dude. I was like, oh, man, what's that called? This, and I was like, I think it's a crab. And he was like,
oh, no.
Say, George, I'm going to need you to say lobster, homie. And I was like, why? He was like,
because I'm a Crip.
Yeah, he was a Crip, and he thought that was disrespect. I was like, oh, shit, you're part of that bullshit? All right, bro. Like, I like you, so I'm going to let that slide. You fucking corrected me. Also, you're cool, homie.
Also, that's entrapment. He was like, hey, what's that thing called? You're like,
yeah,
a crab? He's like, don't say that.
No, we're talking about something on TV because they have a TV in there. It's like you just can't go outside when you want to type shit. It's a joke, bro. It's to scare kids. But so anyway, so there's a lot of like adults like, all right, we got to do, you guys got to act right in society. You guys want to come back. It's like a lot of coaching and shit.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I just got caught up, bro. Like, I don't belong here, you know?
Yeah.
And I started doing everybody's taxes and shit. And now, right. So, cut tie, get out. They're telling me, right, oh, you're lucky right before your birthday, because when you're 16, you're considered an adult and blah, blah. I was like, all right, whatever, dude. So, all right, so you're going to be on. So you got to go to anger management classes and you got to go to Scared Straight. All right. And I was like, whew. So I went, they pick us up in a van at the fucking, some home some other kids live in. And A group home. I guess they had to do other shit. Yeah. So we had two little girls with us, and we went to Fabian Dominguez, which is here in Texas.
Yeah.
And it's like a low security, like chill prison, I guess.
Yeah.
It's like where you go when you have like 5 years. And so we go there, and we all sit in this like auditorium type joint. We're all sitting in the front row. And the two guys that are with us were gay, the counselors. They were like flamboyantly, I think they were fucking too. They were just two gay, like, okay, you sit there. Like, I think they might have been Puerto Rican too or something. They were like,
scoot over.
Yeah, yeah. No, you sit there, and I want you over there, okay? And don't talk. Like, it was just like.
Are you guys playing too much?
Yeah, just like that.
What made you think they were fucking? There was just the chemistry?
Yeah, the chemistry. They were joking behind us, sitting too close, you know? And in my head, I'm just like, these motherfuckers, dude. They have the perfect job. Get the fuck with kids all day. Go
near
home,
the
fuck
jail.
So we all sit in the front row, and here comes the fucking circus, dude. And they're all in white. They're all in white fucking, you know.
Oh, yeah,
fucking,
yeah, yeah.
I mean, they're wearing
short sleeve.
Short sleeve with the white. And
they're all baggy.
Like the sandals and shit.
Yeah.
You hear them with the socks, like doing the fucking. Coming in one by one, and they're handcuffed, and they're all looking at us all crazy already. And then one of the guards comes in, he starts unlocking them. The spokesman, he was this big fucking crazy looking black dude. And big, he's like what's his name? Tiny that just died. What's his name? Zeus?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
He was like Debo, as big as this motherfucker. No teeth in the front.
Nice.
So it was already like. Like, where's his motherfucker's teeth at? And he's just, what's up, boy? He starts barking at us, dude. What's up, motherfuckers? Yeah, y'all in my hood, blah, 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 talking shit. I'm like such a clown. I'm like, do one of these. And I'm looking around. I'm looking around and trying to make friends. Like, yo, do y'all believe this fucking shit? And everybody's like, fucking looking at him. So I'm watching him. He's like, that's right, motherfuckers. We're going to go down the line one by one, bitches, you pussies, and blah, blah, blah. Calls every fucking name in the book. What'd you do, motherfucker? He's like, I stole, blah, blah, blah. Sit the fuck down. All right, what about you, little motherfucker? And goes down to everybody, bro. He goes down to me, and he's cussing people out, dude.
Oh, my God.
Like, what'd you do? Assault and battery. All right, sit the fuck down, tough guy. What about you, motherfucker? The guy next to me had something to prove. He was at the black Dickies.
Oh, had the nice.
Fucking, the khaki dicky pants, had the G Nikes on.
Yeah, the Cortez, back, dude. The Cortez, yeah. Dude. Lokes.
No, he didn't have any looks, but he had
in
the
spirit.
Classic haircut where it was shaved, but slick back long on top, bro.
Yeah.
Fucking clown.
Legendary.
So he's like, he has his chin up when he does this too, right? And I knew, like, don't fucking look at him tough because this guy, his plan is to try to fucking invoke fear in you and make you an example, you know? So he couldn't wait to get to this motherfucker next to me. He's like, so what'd you do, fuck boy? And he's like, I made terroristic threats. It was like 13. And he's in middle school and he fucking He said he was gonna.
Oh man! He
said he was plant a bomb at his fucking
oh, literally terroristic
threats. But the guy, the prisoner, he was like, I don't know what the fuck that means. That's fucking damn, great. Dude. When he said that, oh, and dude, everybody's like shook and shit. I was like, he doesn't know what the. I had to keep in my laughter the whole time, and I'm like holding my gut. I'm like, oh shit, dude, he doesn't know what the fuck terroristic threats mean.
Oh my god.
So the kid explains it. He's like, man, what the fuck is wrong with you, man? What said you claim? He's like, IA. He's like, what the fuck is that? International Assassins. Like, he made up his own gang and shit. Oh my god. And the two counselors are just like, like laughing in the bed. You hear them like,
oh my god,
dude, they're enjoying this like a motherfucker. And so the prisoner's like, man, take off your fucking shoes, homie. And he looks back at the counselors and shit. Take them off. You heard him. Take them off. So he takes off his shoes and he's like, that's right, bitch. Shut the fuck down. I'm going to make you hold my pocket. And he grabs his shoes. Happy birthday, homeboy. It's my homeboy's birthday. And that was his segue to this guy got up. Like, how you doing? Everybody, I'm glad you're here. That way I can tell you my story. And he goes.
Oh, this is a white telling, guy?
Yeah, with no like teeth a, yeah. again. But he looked like a straight pedophile type dude. Tattoos, had whoa. KKK on his shit. He starts telling us about how he's raping people and he enjoys it.
He's raping
He's never. People. This is a 5-year prison, bro.
Yeah, right.
So this is what I found out later about this place. These guys were just liars.
It smells like Febreze in there, probably.
Dude, it was nice. Yeah. All right, so. It gets to the Mexican dude, which I couldn't wait to hear his fucking story.
Oh, nice.
So he comes up and he just blurts out. He's like, I've been here like a while, dude, and I get raped every day.
No way.
Just off the top. I couldn't hold it in. I just started going, oh, my God. Oh, my God. They thought I was crying. I just started to bust out laughing. I was like, oh, my God. No, look at him. Look at him from the back. So the guy's like, I get raped every day because I'm not joining a gang, but I in order to not join, I get raped, okay? And you don't want to be like me. And fucking everybody's like shaking in their boots. So they fucking say, all right, now everybody follow us. And we walk through. We take a tour of this prison.
A tour.
Dude, there's like fucking Pat Benatar playing in the fucking, like, you know what I'm saying? Nice. Like, there's elevator music throughout the prison, bro. So we're walking through. And they're showing us maximum security. They're saying the mafia lives here. Oh, 5 years, bro. 5 years. And so we go out to the yard, and they're like, yes, we're all the fucking big boys, blah, blah. And then we go out to general population, and it's just a bunch of bunks, and it's separated by this little ditch, and there's a chain link fence. When all these fucking animals see little kids, and their job is to scare us. So they run over to it and start like, I'm going to fuck you, little kid. Yeah, I'm going to fuck you. Dude,
so wild,
I started laughing. I'm like, man, there's a lot of pedophiles in here, dude.
Yeah, dude.
Because I'm 15. I got like a little mind of my own, you know. Dude, we had two little girls with us. These little girls had stole makeup from HEB, like $500 worth of makeup from HEB. So they were like felony type shit. But, they, you know, they're kids. So they're not getting in like real trouble. And they started fucking crying when the general population dude saw them. They're like, yeah, oh, shit, there's pussy. Yo, homie, there's pussy here. Yeah, we're going to fuck the dog shit out of you. Get us out.
Oh, started
banging through the gate, dude. They started taking out their dicks. Fucking like I swear to God, fucking the chain link holes and shit. Showing their asses to us and shit. Yeah, I'm going to make you fuck me, too. You fucking calling us, you know, slurs, you know.
Nice. Good respect for you. That was good.
You know what I'm saying?
Good restraint.
Dude, it was just hilarious, bro. We ate lunch there. We went to the fucking cafeteria, which it was not that bad, you know.
What was it? What'd you have?
I think it was like meatloaf and like mashed potatoes. It wasn't like something, you know, I'd order, but it was like, hey, I'm gonna be here.
Yeah.
It's not bad. And people were like, how can you eat? Like, kids were like, how can you eat, man? We're in this prison. I'm like, well, give me your fucking meatloaf, bro. That's my cornbread. So,
nice.
At the end of the day, homeboy still barefoot walking through the prison. And the whole time he was barefoot, dude.
Nice.
And he goes up to, can I have my shoes back, please? And we're already in the van. They're like, you didn't get your shoes back? Oh, my God. Go get your shoes. And he goes.
Go get your own shoes?
He goes back. Yeah. So he goes back. I mean, there's still people walking now, and there's a fucking guard there. He's like, I want my shoes. And the people who were talking shit to us, like, they're like 12 of them. They're all standing by the gate doing this, like you know, trying to, you know, like, it's right, you know, type shit. And so he goes up to the black dude. Can you ask your homeboy if I can have my shoes? He's like, man, get the fuck out of here. And so the white dude just threw him over the fucking fence. And to see this guy, to see this guy do the walk of shame, like he picked up his clothes. I'm like, okay,
wiping his nose,
and he walked out. She was like this back to the. It was a good time. It wasn't that bad, you know.
You know what? What first of all, what a production.
Yeah.
Number one.
Oh yeah.
And you know what? I figured the mystery out.
What was the mystery?
Those gay guys. They were no ordinary gay guys.
You don't think so?
Those were playwrights. Those were the producers.
Oh shit!
Of this play.
Okay.
That's why, like, they were probably in the back, like, mouthing the words along with him. He's like, and I get raped every day. And I knew when I was a little boy, growing up in the streets of San Francisco.
It was nice, you know, and I got in the van. I was like, yo, that shit was wild. I'm looking at these people. They're like, George, how can you even be laughing at a time like this? We just went to prison. I'm like, bro, bitch, I'm never going to go back there. Give me a fucking break. That shit was fucking, that was, it was not a bad Saturday, you know?
Nice. Oh, it was a Saturday.
It was an experience. Yeah, they picked us all up and they took us in those fucking, those like prisoner vans, you know?
Yeah. So, nice. Yeah. That's good. I think, also, like, the hackiness is the number one thing that just,
yeah,
it just jumps out to me. Just them all being like, immediately, hold my pocket, got it, got it.
Yeah.
If you've seen one, also.
I saw it before I went in there.
Yeah.
I saw episodes of it when before I went in there.
You know what? I got it. I got some, I know this is unorthodox, but I'm going to give some advice to those guys, to the scared straight people.
Okay.
Just, all it takes is one. One guy kill a kid once. Just once. You gotta do it.
Thank you for the team.
You gotta kill a kid once, and then the rest of it just holds water.
Yeah. Yeah.
It means something.
They set an example, yeah. Set a precedent.
Or
yeah.
Just hit him. Just, like, hit him on camera.
Fuck it, don't kill a kid. But start a rumor that someone did kill a kid.
Yeah.
Edward said that when he did it, it took a lot of time off of his shit. You were working, like, your time off.
Yeah.
So, he was like, yeah, I was lying like a motherfucker. I don't give a fuck. I murdered 18 people, and you could be 19 and shit like that.
Oh, do they write their own material?
I think they go over it, yeah, before, yeah. But it's really, like, no holds bar. You can say whatever the fuck you want to these kids.
There's no way there's not a dress rehearsal.
I mean,
there's a 1,000% practice.
So you're going to come rehearsal. Out first. Blase, blase, rape, 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 kill people. You do you. You're going to come off soft that way because they're going to need the break.
Draw them in.
Yeah. You I don't know why I'm still talking in that accent, but.
Yeah. Dude, it's, yeah, that's for sure a production. Mm. That is, like, there's probably a company that does that. They produce the.
The scared straight guys, yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm. Wow, what a resume. You don't have a felony? Sorry, we can't hire you for this.
Oh, nice.
That's crazy.
Nice. Jobs to the people.
Yeah, yeah.
That's great. Scared straight. What would you say to a kid? Say if there was a bad kid in front of you.
Bad kid in front of me, mm-hmm. and I'm trying to get him not to go to prison?
Yep. You want to scare him to act better. We can't. I don't know. You can't say scared straight anymore.
Yeah, you can. Oh, shit. Maybe not.
I mean, scared straight if you're
it's
into that.
It's not scared heterosexual. It's not like the ones, you know, you go to church and they.
That's the real, that's the OG scare straight.
Yeah, that's a scared straight.
Hey guys, it's me. Just wanted to step in real quick. First of all, sorry for the background noise here. Do not feel like finding the remote. So you're just going to have to deal with that real quick. All right. I just wanted to step in and let you know that kind of intro this next segment here. This is a segment with a buddy of mine, Justin Byers. He's not dumb. He's not a dumb kid. He's not informed in any capacity. All right. So I thought it would be funny if he just came on and read me some questions that he has. And then I flipped it on him. I read him some questions. So it's a great segment. So enjoy that. Also, if you have any questions for Justin for the next episode, send them my way. At Problematic Pod on everything. Bye.
It's just inquisitive. He grew up in a house without the internet.
Huh?
I don't want to say that he doesn't know shit, but there's a whole lot of shit he never noticed. It's just inquisitive. Hey, Justin, tell him what time it is.
Okay, you know what? I actually am going to ask you a question.
Okay.
Okay. I've thought of a question.
Okay.
Why do deer stand in the road? Why don't they move?
Oh, man. First of all, I think you're giving deer a lot of credit. I don't even think they know that it's a road.
Wow.
They don't know what a road is, first of all.
But it's so simple.
Yeah, it's pretty simple. It's like, this is where things go faster than fuck. Dude, things go real fast here, and they don't know. They don't stop. Like, on that level, they don't even understand that. They're just like, all right, this is a part of the
That's where my wife was yeeted, but...
Oh, and maybe those guys do. Maybe those, like, guys that have, like, Vietnam flashbacks. Like, the deer that are just, like, not okay. Maybe they understand that, but...
I think those are the ones that freeze when they're like...
Oh, they're like, I knew... Or maybe they're suicidal. That's the answer. They're suicidal. It can't be that great being a deer... What do you fucking do all day? You gotta be suicidal. What are you gonna do? All right, here's a thought exercise. You're a deer.
Yep.
What are you gonna do?
I mean, it's mainly grass dependent.
You're hungry.
Yeah, I'm eating grass.
Am
I bombing? Am I bombing as a deer?
No, deer are bombing. Cause their shit sucks, dude. Hey, deer, your shit sucks.
Yeah, pretty much. Don't get eaten and eat.
Yeah, that's it. And those are the only two things to worry about. And you can't even manage to stay the fuck out of the road. You don't got bills or nothing. You don't even have to worry about typos. You're fucking out here, just like what.
This is how hard it is for me to, like, pivot when you said you don't have bills. I was thinking, like, a duck bill. I was like, that's true. They don't.
They don't. That's true. Dude. Hey, but do they got bills, though? Do they got bills? No, they don't. The classic, do he get paid? Hey, but do he get paid? Yeah. Dear, I'll tell you, the real answer is, there's no reason for them to be alive anyway. There's no point to them being alive.
Damn. Milwaukee, change your team's name.
Yep.
Change your team's name. What would you name it?
Milwaukee team?
What would you change the Milwaukee Bucks name to?
The Blondes. The Milwaukee Blondes. And it would just be a guy with a blonde beard.
Oh, nice.
It would just be my buddy Dale Cheeseman's face.
They all just have that.
Yep, just flannel shirt. Just... A nice blonde beard and just an eager smile.
Amazing. Well, I might just be curious about animals, but like, why do dogs think peeing on something like for their territory? Like, why do they think that works?
Ooh. Well, let me answer your question with a question. If you pee on something. You fucking own that. Nobody else wants it. Right? I happen to love these basketball shorts I'm wearing right now. If you peed on them when I wasn't looking, you can have them, dude. You can have them. Also, they don't have, like, markers. Or, like, anything to write their name. They don't even know about it. They don't even know about language. So they just, like, that's all they got, dude. It's just like, oh, I don't know. What do I got? I don't know how to even. They don't even know how to spit. Dogs, those fools. All they know how to do is shit and piss.
That's such a surface level way of thinking about things.
Dude, too. Welcome to the dog's life. Just like, dude, just surface level, just like, what do I got? All right.
Oh my god,
dude. Here's the real problem.
I'm gonna pee in your house. I want this house.
Oh, no! It would definitely work, dude. You pee on this microphone, it's yours, dude.
But, like, peeing is tricky. Especially, you know, it's harder for us. We got pants. Think about if you didn't have pants. Like, just going around just being like, hey, what's up with that couch? Oh, that couch is mine, dude.
I think they're like, what did you pee on most? you know, after a certain time.
Oh, yeah, dude. What's saturated?
Yeah.
You really saturated the market with your own urine. So...
And yeah. if two dogs pee on something, is it like a gang war where there's like?
Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, I don't think they respect boundaries.
I don't think so either.
They're, yeah, they are gang banging. They're set tripping for sure. Damn. So yeah. So that's just what they got. That's why. All right. So I have a couple questions for you.
Shoot.
Your eyes got big as fuck. Are you okay? We don't have to put this in, but they're like good questions.
I'm ready.
Okay, what ingredients do you need to put into a bowl to make a cake?
Eggs. Okay. Cake mix.
Oh no, dude.
No cake mix.
No cake mix.
Like what kind of cake? Like pancakes?
just. No, no, not pancakes. Okay. Like a cake.
Fuck. Eggs. I'm going eggs, milk, flour, and if you're kind of... I like a little like cornbread meal.
Okay, all right. Dude. All right, that's good. You nailed it. That's perfect. Okay. Eggs, flour, cornbread meal, and milk. All right, dude. And that cut to the video of us making that cake. Oh, man, dude. Also, how about this one? All right, here's another one. Can you name the reindeer? The famous reindeer.
Wow, wait.
From Santa Claus. From Santa Claus's house.
Yo, Rudolph.
Okay. All of them.
Oh, what?
He said, what?
Dude, there's mad reindeer.
No, there's not. There's like a big, there's 10.
Okay. So it's Rudolph. I think there's Nixon.
Yep. Yeah.
Isn't there a Dixon too?
Yep. Rudolph Nixon Dixon. All right.
Is there a Scarborough?
Yeah.
Dude. Yes. I'm bombing.
No.
Oh wait. CRISPR. Rudolph the reindeer. Dude, they don't say any other reindeer in this?
No.
It's all
CRISPR.
Are they all like Scandinavian?
Dude, I can't help you at all. I'm not allowed to help.
Harriet?
Okay, that's 4. Okay. Oh my god.
I feel like they all rhyme with like Simpson. Like, don't they all like. They're like.
Oh, fuck. Ow, dude.
Ow. Oh, dude. There's Prancer.
Yeah. Oh, damn.
There's Prancer, Dancer, Cancer. Oh, no.
Damn, dude, that was Lance. Crazy. All right, so wait, can we just do a quick recap?
I think so.
Who do we have? We got Nixon, Dixon.
Yeah, we got Nixon, Dixon.
Harriet.
Harriet. Rudolph.
Rudolph, of course. Dancer.
Yeah, Dancer. Prancer.
Wait, Dancer, Prancer. That's 7.
Dancer, Prancer.
Lance.
Yeah, Lance.
You need 2 more. That's it.
Felix?
Okay, very good. The last one. You got this one.
Okay.
Oh, fuck you. Scarborough. We forgot about Scarborough.
Yeah, Scarborough. Okay, got him.
Scarborough. Wait. I'll tell you this. I'll tell you as a bonus. Dixon is not one.
No?
No. Nixon was one, but so you still do need one.
I can't believe there's a Nixon.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm feeling pretty good. let me think. Oh, yeah. Saint Nick.
Nicholas.
Nice. Here we go.
Well done.
Big Nicky, they called him.
Very electric. That was amazing. The dude
right behind.
Oh, man. Rudolph. Fucking hell, dude. My stomach hurts for real. Dude, that was amazing.
All the other reindeer called him names. Dude, they should look at their own names.
Yeah, dude. Look at your name, Harriet.
Lance,
dude.
You asshole.
Lance, you piece of shit. Oh, man. That was amazing. All right, that's great. That's a wrap. That's fantastic. Man.
I don't think there's not
everybody.
Everybody. Every single person. Yeah.
Wait. No.
Yeah. Everybody.
Pol Pot.
Everybody. Every single soul goes to heaven.
Pol Pot needed a PR team. He was like a bad guy.
Everybody.
But he's not respected in like the
everybody.
Bad guys.
Everybody.
Why? So is there a hell?
No.
There's only heaven.
Only heaven. There's no hell.
I kind of like that.
Yeah.
That's good. I can just choose to believe it.
Can you hold a grudge in heaven? No.
God seems pretty grudgy.
No, he's not.
I'm a jealous God. He owns his own mistakes.
No, that's what man said about him. Do you think you can trust the words of man? Fuck no.
Then why would he let that happen? Why would he let him misinterpret it?
He doesn't give a fuck.
That's what I think.
You let them haters hate, homie?
Oh, yeah. Throw salt from a distance, dude.
Exactly, dude. Damn. And then they get up there like, wait, there's all these gay people here. Like, yeah, bitch. Oh, what do you think it was tailor-made, stupid? No.
Oh, my God. Hold on.
This is fucking bliss and joy.
Hey, Google, play Look At Me Now by Chris Brown.
That's the devil, though.
Are you fucking out? This is the one chance you have. I never even use you. Google. Well, I was going for the, why are you hating outside the club? You can't get in.
There you go.
Damn. Yeah, it seems like a lot of work to keep grudges.
Keep grudges. Plus, you know, we just got mental illness as like a real thing in like the last 50 years.
Mm.
So imagine someone who's sick down here. You know, acting right in heaven. You know what I mean?
Oh, okay. But they wouldn't be the same person.
No, they wouldn't. They would fucking kill the shit that they, you know, that they got in trouble for down here. Yeah.
Yeah. Like me knowing about sports. I wouldn't even know anything about sports up there. That would no longer be retarded or
autistic.
Yep.
That's not necessarily like a bad thing.
To not know. I would no longer know about sports.
No. That's not a bad thing to be autistic.
Oh, yeah. That's true.
You know what I'm saying?
That is true.
Yeah.
I don't know why
you would say that. Whatever.
Oh, yeah. Nice. Damn.
That's not like a pedophile who hates to rape kids.
But just has to.
He hates it, but he just has no choice. It's built in him.
It's like a sneeze?
He, you know, it's super illegal, dude. It's fucking crazy, you know?
It's the most illegal.
Yeah, the most, one of the most illegal, yeah.
That is, it's worse than murder. I think. Yes?
Up there. It's up there. I don't know if it's worse than murder.
Well, everybody goes to heaven. So murder is probably pretty good for you.
Yeah. I mean, why not? Yeah. Yeah.
There you go.
I mean, if someone's sick enough to murder somebody, you know, the people, I mean, imagine all the sociopaths, all these gangsters and shit, and all these people who murder people for this or for that, for money and all that. They're sociopaths. There's something wrong with them, right?
Yeah.
If you believe in like mental health, if you believe in mental health, there's no right and wrong. There's no evil and bad guy. It's just we are, you know?
Yeah.
So,
damn. Yeah. That was good.
Seriously.
It
sounds that sometimes I talk like this.
Yeah.
It, excuse me. People tell me, I didn't realize this, it sounds like Satan worship type shit. Like, people say this to me, like, do you worship this? I'm like, no, I don't. And what's all this right, no right and wrong? I'm like, because it's the part of the universe. There's no right and wrong in the fucking universe, is there? You know what I mean?
Whoa, do people say that? People are so dumb.
I know, people say people it to me, so and I didn't realize how I was coming across and shit, you know?
Ugh.
It's crazy, dude, yeah, yeah.
That's crazy.
To me, there is no right and wrong. I know there's suffering,
yeah,
and there's misery.
Yeah.
But there's not really a right and wrong type shit, you know?
Well, it's like, it's case by case, right? So, like, for us...
What's right to you might be wrong to them.
Yeah.
And shit like that, yeah.
Damn, dude, look at us.
Yeah.
Look at...
I like to philosophize, like, homie, you know what I'm saying? Seriously, though, seriously. I really like to just sit down and just ponder. You don't ever do that? I'm telling you, that's why you're like, do you like being alone? I'm like, I love being alone, bro.
Yeah.
I get to just be enveloped by this fucking... I don't know, man. I think in my 30s, it's all coming together. You know what I mean?
Oh, I feel that a little bit.
You feel that a little bit? Wasted energy.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
like,
yeah.
I can't. Yeah. That's my pet peeve, wasting energy now.
Yeah, or using any energy at all.
I find the quickest way to do something, and I follow that model, you know.
Nice.
Any other, you know, it takes a lot for me to leave my house.
Oh, for sure.
It takes a lot for me to be like, I can go without bologna for a couple of days or some shit. You know, like, fuck it, man. I'll just eat the turkey.
This quarantine was so fire.
Yeah, it was nice, right?
I loved it.
I hate saying that.
Well, I mean,
a lot of people did go through it. I know a lot of friends of ours, people we know went crazy, you know, and shit like that. But,
damn.
It was all right. You know?
I loved it. Yeah. It was like being sick. Yeah, I like being sick sometimes. You ever like that?
I can't stand being sick now.
So there's nobody expects anything of you.
I like being alone and healthy, not like... yeah, no, I can't do that.
That's the sick voice?
That's the sick voice. Like,
God damn it! It
smells in here. Are you making Korean food? Get the fuck out of here.
Oh, man, dude. I didn't know the Koreans were going to catch a hot one.
No, if my girl burns like muffin... I don't know. I smell like Korean. I have like a... Korean food, like, is that kimchi? Get the fuck out of here with that shit.
Does your girl bake?
No. She's almost worthless.
Damn. Baking's hard, though. I feel her.
Yeah. She does. She's not a cook. That's one thing I wish.
Are you?
Yeah, yeah, of course.
What's your signature dish?
I like trying out new things. I don't really have a signature
dish.
Oh,
you do. Everybody does.
You think so? No? No? Well, what's yours?
Ziti, baked ziti.
That's fucking nothing, bro. What's cheese and noodles? Give me a fucking break.
Jesus.
Get some sauce. That's your fucking dish?
I thought we were in the trust tree.
No, that's
clearly
fine.
I've been judged. Listen.
I think that was part of the problem.
Well, here's what I do something different is I put a little bit of, have you ever heard of this? Red wine into the sauce.
Oh, okay, okay. That's a little different.
Nobody's ever done that.
It's a little different. I make a mean soup.
What's okay?
It's what the Mexicans call caldo de res.
Oh, the king's soup.
Yeah. No, the res.
Res?
Yeah, res. It's like meat.
Oh.
Yeah. Like beef.
Oh.
Beef chunk. But you gotta boil that bitch for fucking ever. So it gets super tender, potatoes, carrots, some cilantro. It's fucking it's really good, man. I make it like my father. My father makes it like fucking the best. And I
love
make it
some.
Just like him. Oh, yeah. I fucking, come on.
oh, dude.
With the rice on the side. Oh, it's fucking delicious.
We should do that.
On a cold day.
We should do that. We should do potluck.
Let's do it.
You know, I grew up all the time. My parents potluck this, potluck that.
Yeah, yeah.
We never do it.
I've noticed a lot of people in our generation. Can I say that?
Yeah.
Males cook. A lot of males cook, man.
Yeah, shouts to us.
Honestly.
Fellas, let's go.
My mom made me independent as fuck, dude.
I
can iron my own shirts. I can sew. I can fucking, you know, my dad does all that shit too. But I can fucking cook for myself. My mom doesn't cook. My sister doesn't cook.
Nice.
My wife doesn't cook. My brother, he used to bake and cook all kinds of shit. You
damn.
Know?
Baking is tough. It's like math.
That's an art, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, it's math. I was never good at math. To me, it's complete magic. I don't understand it at all.
Yeah.
Yep. Don't talk when the cake's rising and shit. I don't understand that.
Is that a thing?
That's a thing, yeah. Ooh, signature dish?
Yeah.
Cupcake lasagna. Look it up. you won't go back to the fucking dumb block of lasagna that we're used to. That the little you make the whole thing.
Oh.
You get a cupcake pan.
Nice. That's how nice.
And you still boil the noodles and everything. Okay. But you use a cup and you just cut out circle, pop it in, feta with the meat.
Feta?
Yeah, bro. Or no,
ricotta.
Yeah, ricotta. I'm sorry. Feta goes on top of everything. Anyway, so whoa. Oh dude, yeah, bro. And you put the cheese and meat. Then you put another circle out of the noodle. And you put that on top. You just layer it. It's like three different layers. And it comes out like a little fucking cupcake.
Bite size.
And you get two of them holes on the side. Oh, my God, dude.
Can I help you workshop it real quick?
Let's do it.
Cupcake lasagna.
Mm-hmm.
Close. Very close.
Okay.
I'm thinking more cake than lasagna. But, so it's a cake. I think I just invented layer cake. But okay, so there's a bottom layer.
That's regular lasagna, homie.
No, it's cake.
Okay.
There's cake.
Oh, different cake. Actual cake.
It's cake.
Okay.
And then frosting.
Mm-hmm.
Cake. Frosting. Cake. Maybe ice cream. You put ice cream. That's the lasagna. And you call it lasagna. You brand it. But it's dessert.
You know what? I stopped being negative and I started just saying, that's interesting.
Oh, come on, dude. You would love it.
I've had it before, bro.
Cake?
I've had cake before. Okay. I've had
all right, just
layered cake before.
Yeah. A lot of people probably haven't out there. Get yourself some cake.
Cake it up.
Cake it out.
Cake daddy.
Dude, I'm caked up and caked out. Know what I'm talking about.
Dude. Oh, man, I love the fact that you're from Houston so much, bro.
It fits. It does fit.
It's refreshing, you know. Houston, which I don't necessarily like the city.
Nobody does, apparently.
But it's different vibe out there, dude.
Yeah.
Like, your Mexicans out there are, like, legit fucking Mexicans.
Oh, yeah.
And out here, it's like this morph of, like, yo, is that a 6'2" fucking... Brown guy? Yeah. That's crazy.
Everybody looks like an MMA fighter out here, kind of.
Yeah, a little bit, yeah. Well, yeah. I don't think you've been to, like, some of the hoods out here, though.
I'd love to go. Where's the hood? DMX, where the hood at.
Where the hood at, yeah.
Slice that
in. We can go to the west side or the south side, driving quickly.
Oh, really? What about Marbach?
East side.
Is Marbach a thing?
No, not really, dude. That's where... Okay, so the east side, if you get a little bit of money, you move to the northeast side, right?
Okay.
If you live the south side, you move to the north side. If you live on the west side, you move to the northwest side. Marbach is the northwest side.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's like, oh, she became a nurse. So now she lives on Marbach.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, always a nurse, huh?
Straight shot to her house.
Dude, nurses are so bad.
Yeah.
Nurses are always bad. Like, it's crazy. I remember one time my dad had to get heart surgery. Shout out. It worked.
Thank God.
Yeah.
That's scary shit.
Yeah, but meanwhile, the whole time, all the nurses were so bad.
What do you mean? Like?
Hot.
Nice.
Yeah.
Can you say that? You're good?
Yeah, I can say it. I'm saying it.
Maybe that was part of the problem, dude.
You think I was hurting?
So nurses are nice, though, dude.
Dude, that's why I say,
no class. But super nice.
Well, it's great that Beyonce became famous, or else there would just be a nurse named Beyonce.
Oh, yeah, dude. Oh, lovely.
Can you imagine? God.
I've seen. There's nurses that are, like, trying to get into Maxim and shit.
Yeah.
And they're all fucking inked up, tatted everywhere. Yeah. Big old fake titties, big bubble lips and shit.
Yeah.
And they're white, you know. Some of these Indian nurses.
Oh, oh, wow. Shout out.
Oh, God, dude.
Yeah. Meanwhile, the parents are still kind of disappointed. Like, you're supposed to be a doctor.
No, I don't think so, dude. Nurses get a lot of respect, dude.
Yeah?
Piss, shit, and cum on their hands.
Damn. All in one.
Every day. All day. For the most part. Yeah.
Cum?
Sometimes, yeah. Have you ever had an old man... And he's just jerking off because he's demented. He's just beating off and shit. Yeah. I mean, all walks of life,
God.
0 to 99, all types of mental issues.
Oh, my God.
There's a nurse there that has to either pass meds or take care or something. You know what I mean?
And he's just
And sometimes they don't care. I've had a dude show me his nuts. I've had a woman show me her tits.
Wait, you're a nurse?
Nah, I work in the medical field, though, you know?
Whoa!
Yeah, yeah.
Do you do medicine in a field?
I do.
That seems dangerous.
I do COVID testing.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
For, okay.
I look at them and I go, nah.
Damn.
If they look like, yeah, I go, maybe.
You're like, you ask yourself, dude. Didn't even need to come here.
And the vaccine? Get out of here. Nice, dude. Jesus has your back, bro.
That Ash Wednesday vaccine.
Yeah, Ash Wednesday?
Isn't that coming up?
Passed.
Fuck.
Yeah, we're in the middle of it.
Are you Catholic?
I used to be, yeah.
Do you give up? What was the best thing you gave up for Lent?
That's dumb shit. Like, when I used to smoke cigarettes.
Oh, that's tough.
It was very tough. Candy. Like, dumb shit. Nothing really. I mean, I'm not a fucking crazy person. You know what I mean?
These are all pretty tough things to give up.
They're pretty tough, but they're, like, very mild and, like, you know, people giving up, like, I'm going to give up my rights to my kid, you know, or shit like that. I'm not gonna hit my wife this whole 40 days, you know?
Oh, somehow.
Shit like that. I'm not going to drink for 40 days for God. Like, dude, you have a problem. If you're giving up, if you have to give it up for God, then you have a problem, you know, shit like that. So,
yeah.
Are you Catholic or what?
I used to dabble.
Isn't that crazy? That whole thing boggles my fucking mind.
Catholicism?
People can still follow that shit. It's fucking bananas.
Yeah, it was, it's weird. It's creepy. It's
weird, dude.
It's creepy. When you go back, and I don't mean to judge. I mean.
I do.
You do?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you should probably go back and read the Bible. Cause
which Jesus one? Like, part one or part two? Part one, there's Jesus isn't even born or anything.
Oh, that's true.
Part two, it mentioned him a little bit.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, he's not even in the fucking movie. It's like The Godfather Part 2.
Yeah.
Michael was only in it for a little bit.
Like, there you go.
But he was the main character.
It was the main character. I mean, that they made him the main character, yeah. I guess. But, you know, whatever. You know?
Yeah.
I think he was real. But maybe some of the shit he did just got blown up out of, you know, got hyped up a little bit.
Do you believe, like, the walking on water?
No.
Okay, what about?
I believe they were like, yo, that motherfucker saved that drowning kid. That motherfucker was walking on water when he grabbed that dude. He fucking grabbed him out. He ran back to shore. That shit was bananas, yo. And all of a sudden, he walked on water.
Oh, see, when I die, do that for me.
So hype up something about
you? Oh, hype up everything about me.
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah.
And I mean, I'm being deadly serious.
The more people you help out in this life, the legend, your legend will grow.
Oh, you know? Man, I'd love to have a legend.
Well, start it. Go all help right. out. Go volunteer at the shelter. Do the Habitat for Humanity. God damn it.
Hey, I don't know about that.
You meet some crazy villains down there, bro.
Oh, no. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't want to have a conversation with a good.
You never had a bus stop conversation?
Oh, man, yeah. Just a dude talking about how to talk to women.
You ever had a drunk guy conversation?
Oh, someone's
fucking out of their mind talking shit, yeah.
Yeah.
I had a conversation at the Tiger not too long ago. This girl was, we have the clip too, Josh was playing it and shit. This girl was barred out.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Do not do bars.
Don't do bars.
Don't do Xanax.
And she was
do
doing
not
it.
Do it.
To get to that point.
Oh,
she wasn't having
no.
a good time. She was doing it to ruin everybody else's time.
Oh, my God.
And she was talking super slow. And I was like, I was like, why are you talking so fucking blah? You better watch out. And I'm being an idiot. And
yeah.
Like, because I'm sad. And I'm like, oh, here we go, dude. So at that point, I was like, I'm taking everybody else down with me. Fuck it. So 38 minutes later. We got to the reason why she's super sad, because her cousin got shot in the face, her dad disowned her, and that's when people started walking. And when they left, they're like, shit just got too real. People were upset at the fact that this girl was so sad. So I think in that instance, we made a difference. You know what I mean?
With her?
Yeah, and I made friends with someone else. Apparently this other lady, her dad wasn't shit either. So I'm like, y'all should talk because healing begins now.
No way, dude.
Yeah, dude. It was fucking dope, man.
Look at that.
Not good for the audience, but everybody else was dying laughing.
It was on stage?
On stage, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I thought you were talking about outside.
Fuck no, dude. It was on stage, known. Bro.
Yeah. George is a realist.
It That's was fucking best. Dope as fuck, dude.
Good for you. It dude, create dope. Moments.
Yeah. I thought someone had touched her, but that wasn't the case.
You touched her. Heart.
Yeah. I was for sure, like, someone touched you, dude. There's no way you're this distraught out in the world. No way. Touched me. I was like, I don't know.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't do that.
When's the last time you helped somebody out, huh?
I mean,
stop bullshitting, man.
I mean, I help people all the time. I talk to people.
When's the last time you thought about someone else besides yourself, which I think was part of the problem?
I mean, part of the problem of the breakup that I'm going through. That's yeah.
How brutal is it, honestly?
It's amicable.
Real.
It's amicable.
That doesn't mean anything. That means you're being a bigger person.
No, we're both on the, we're both like same page.
We are not friends. I'm not friends with anybody I've ever had sex with. You
know what I mean? Quote it.
Can't do it.
That's great.
Can't do it.
I am. I've never had a breakup where we were ops afterwards. I've never had it.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just who I am, though.
Yeah.
But good news, team. We did it. We got ads. And I am going to, and this is something I'll probably clip out, but I do want us to use reverence here and be very respectful of the sponsors. So you can go first.
You're telling me, bro.
There you go. So this, okay, sponsor number one.
Is this real?
Yes. Jesus Christ. That's how you're starting it? wait. That's how you, for real. You're
going to fuck this. Not real, George, bro.
This is not cool. Oh, my God.
You're a motherfucker.
Dude, this is not okay, dude.
Hold on.
What are you doing? They're gonna pull the... They're not gonna sponsor it.
You motherfucker.
Come on.
Okay, hold on. All
right, I would like to say my sincere apologies to sponsor number one.
We can cut all that out. Let's just get into it.
Okay, thank you.
My first
Jesus.
Or you first, dude?
Go ahead, but pull it together.
I will. Hold on, dude.
Jesus.
This is not real, okay?
Be respectful, dude. Why are you being so disrespectful?
Damn, I thought you had it, bro.
Come on, bro.
I seriously thought it was a thing.
Oh, come on. All right, pull it together.
I'm
pull
a fast together. Reader, dude.
I'm all only right, laughing because you are, by the way. I'm very upset.
Yes, totally.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to read like radio guy. Boot okay. Scoot Moon Saloon, located on I-10 West. This galaxy's first and only outer space themed country western bar. Are you a nerd who loves science but also boot-scented pickup trucks? Boy, goddamn howdy. Do we have a heterosexual butt fucking place for you? It's not about sex. We just mean business. Order a Lone Star or an ice cold glass of our moonshine du jour. Right? Yep. Over 150 arcade games. What the fuck? Over 150 arcade games you could play in between line dances. From Neil deGrasse Tyson to Neil McCoy. Sometimes you want to go where everyone knows you're lame. It's the Boot Scoot Moon Saloon.
Well, I mean...
That's the stupidest shit. You motherfucker. This thing's been there for an hour and a half. Oh my god, dude.
I don't know if that's gonna fly with good people over there at the Boot Scoot Moon
Saloon.
I think
this was part of the problem, dude. I can't drink. Hold on. I want to hear yours. Okay, hold
Jesus.
On.
All right, and now I'm going to show you how professionalism and respect does it like this.
Sure.
Do you miss craftsmanship? How long has it been since you've seen someone work with care and dedication? Well, the good folks at Blue Raz Boards want to change that. Each and every skateboard deck is carefully hand-whittled from river trees. That's cottonwoods for you city folk. Each one is rigorously tested and calibrated to weigh exactly 25 to 27 pounds each. Take it to the skate park or simply use it as a coffee table. Hey, test its limits. Go nuts. We used one the other day to chop down a tree. What do you say? Put us to the test over at bluerazboards.info. I think maybe they'll probably stay a sponsor. But,
oh, my God, dude.
I mean, you hate to see that. Ugh. That was, I mean, so good luck to me, I'd like to say, getting another.
Definitely, man. Hope you keep them on.
I mean, yeah. So thanks for nothing. What do you have a problem?
Yeah.
Okay, let's get into that.
I just want you to just let it go.
That's your problem?
Yeah.
You want me to cry?
I need you not to cry necessarily, at least not in front of me, but just like, this is devastating.
To you.
Yeah.
You were rooting for it.
I thought you guys were good. Nah, I just thought you guys were good. I'll see you guys on TikTok.
Oh, shut the fuck up, dude. Shut the fuck up, dude. I'm going to bite your nose. I swear to God, if you you keep down this line of...
I just thought, you know, social media is not life, man. But, you know, I find this out.
Oh, my God. I can't
believe just, you know... It's devastating.
It's devastating. You're choked up, it seems.
Yeah, I really am. What? And I'm not going to say, you said don't take sides.
Yeah.
But it has to be her, dude.
You're taking her side. I knew it.
No, I'm taking your side.
Oh, okay. Okay, thank you. Okay.
Like, she has to be the problem, bro.
Okay.
Like, there's no way. Because you're such a nice, laid back. But you're telling me you're super selfish and cold. So maybe, you know, I don't know that side of you.
I've never heard it worded quite like that.
Yeah. Like, if you're like, incapable of, like, communication and, you know, intimacy or whatever you said.
I
just feel like, you know, maybe she tried her best now. Or I don't know. I'm back and forth, you know?
Yeah, I think, well, now I am, too.
Mm.
Now hearing about how bad I am.
I just wish... I wish y'all would have talked to me before, you know.
Well, I mean, but you are, to be clear, you are on my side.
Of course, dude. Come on, man.
All right. I knew that.
You know?
I knew that. I didn't think you were going to go the other way at all.
No, I wouldn't do that.
Yeah.
What I don't like is the fact that y'all made it public.
The breakup?
Yeah.
We got to let people know.
No, you don't. You don't let nobody know. They can just find out when they find out. Oh, yeah. You guys aren't together. No, they haven't been for a long time.
Oh, you didn't like press release? We're
friends. Yeah, I thought that was a little much because that was almost like, hey, you know, I'm available, homie. You know, yada, yada.
Oh, yeah. No, it was. We did that because we wanted to show that we were unified in it. We were like, same team.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just both on the same page. We, like, put it out at the same... Like, we both hit send at the same time.
Yeah.
So...
I just, you know... I don't involve a lot of people in my thing anyway. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you don't. I don't even know what your family looks like.
Yeah, no, yeah, of course not.
And I never will, I get the sense.
No, you will eventually.
No, I never will. You're never going to have me over for the call, though.
What are we going to do? Tell me what we're going to do. We're going to talk comedy... And bullshit. I'm not watching any game. I'm not fucking, you know, you're going to be bored.
Why?
And
never be bored.
I'm going to be with my girl, my family. You're going to be there by yourself, like looking like, you know, or whatever you're going to do.
Whoa. Wait, you know? Okay, this is interesting. So we'd have to have a play date. We'd have to meet at neutral ground where we'd have toys or whatever to play with.
Yeah, man.
Do you like video games?
Nah, not at all.
What do you like? Comedy?
I like working with my hands.
Woodwork.
Shit like that.
Shout out to Blue Raz Boards.
Straight up.
I would love to woodwork.
I like drinking moonshine.
I've got the place for you.
Boot Scoot Saloon.
Boot Scoot's is Lone Stars Moon Shine.
Boom.
I thought that was very good. How they, I thought very that was
clever.
Very creative.
I thought
how
it was very clever.
They
I
did that.
Read it through my tears. It was beautiful.
Do you really like woodwork and shit?
I really do. So what my problem is, though.
Okay.
Getting back to that.
Okay, let me make this clear. What is your problem?
I don't know where I fit in as far as, like, the political trend that's going on.
Oh, wow. That's good.
Yeah.
That's good. So it's like a changing of the guard, kind of.
Is it?
Yeah.
With what?
Of the presidency.
Yeah. But this whole, like, red and blue and
yeah
nonsense.
Yeah.
Each side does bad, each side does good.
Yeah, I think those are the only people I trust, people like you.
Yeah.
People who are like, okay, well, this, I mean, you can't tell me these people aren't goofy sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
You, like, just, also, I hate to quote someone bad. I hope this doesn't get me canceled, but Rush Limbaugh said one time, politics yes. is not like a thing. It's not like a line. It's a circle.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, it's not far left and far right. It's a circle. So, like, on it goes around, and those same people are equally as crazy.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
They're equally as nuts. So I think, I don't know. So let's go down the list. What do you, okay, so number one, guns.
What is the issue with guns?
Do you want them? Do you want to take them away?
I want them.
Okay.
I have them.
Yeah, it's already too late.
I'm responsible, you know?
Yeah.
Criminals and crazy people aren't responsible with them.
Yeah.
But how do you bring them down? A guy with a gun comes in and brings them down. So it's definitely needed.
Well, I got to tell you folks out there, the cat's out of the bag. People already got guns.
People have got guns.
So, I mean, what are you going to do?
What you're going to do is bring the prices fucking crazy high.
For guns?
Yeah.
They're already pretty high.
You can't get rid of them? Well, they were low a couple years ago.
Should have bought the
super
dip.
Low, bro. Super low. The AR-15 I had in the pawn shop.
Dude.
Pawn shop's the only way to go, by the way.
Why? I hate pawn shops. I don't agree with them.
Because you can do, like, layaway. It's super sad.
They're bad people, pawn shop owners.
Nah. Oh, yeah, definitely. They prey off the whatever. But
the tow truck drivers of shop owners.
You get a fucking deal, you know?
Yeah.
And they do layaway, so it's like whatever.
Best I could do for you is
this,
probably
this AR-15 that I wanted, they just marked it up like crazy, dude. It was like $750. They marked it up like $2,500. And I was like, why is that fucking so high? Jeff, he was like, oh, man, you know, the prices, everything's going up because the Dems are going to take away the guns, you know, so we got to make ours while we can. And I was like, you motherfucker, dude. I don't blame you on me, but it's like, damn, you know me, you know.
That is the thing that's crazy. It's like it's best for the gun people when the ops are in the office.
Yeah.
Definitely. The ops fist.
Ops, yeah. And I don't know, you know, Trump was a crazy person, but he did some good.
Yeah, he's pretty funny.
He did some bad.
Yeah.
This new guy, Biden.
Mm.
He did bad already.
What, promised like drone stuff?
Yeah, bro. That's fucking crazy, man.
Drone stuff sucks.
To continue. I don't know what report he got on his desk, you know, what intel he had, but just hearing that is like, damn, dog, it's been like a month.
Oh, it was new drone shit?
Yeah, he just bombed Syria. You come on.
Already?
Yeah, bro. You didn't hear that shit?
They don't talk about it on SportsCenter. I don't know about it.
Oh, fuck, dude.
Damn, drone already?
Strike, 24 points. Yeah, man. Oh, he already bombed a bunch of shit, dude. So
that was mad fast. That's like, that's crazy.
He hasn't done anything about student loans yet. No executive order. He hasn't
helped, minimum wage?
He hasn't helped DACA out yet. Minimum wage hasn't gone up. I mean, he can make an executive order. Hang on, I heard something. What was that?
I got a puppy outside.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Great.
I'm for capitalism, and I'm for, you know, socialist policies too. I want to take care of the people who are sick, but I want to make some fucking money.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah,
let me make some fucking money, bro.
Here's okay.
Stop
here's
taxing
the answer.
Me so much on these highways that are never fucking finishing. What the fuck?
I got the answer. Worst advice you ever. Be the change you want to see. not saying run for office, mm-hmm. bigger than that, mm. Your own party.
My own party.
You're going to make your own party. And it's going to be branded, and you're going to have all this. That's an untapped.
Like the Brewster's Millions party.
You can call it whatever you want.
Don't vote for anybody.
That's amazing. Yeah. The Richard Pryor based.
Well.
And, you know, I'm not saying it'll be a religion, but.
Yeah.
I mean, politics is religion. How many times have people said that? Dude,
I want to start my own religion so fucking bad.
Do you?
Yeah. And
there you go.
You can, dude.
You can.
Tax free.
Shout out to L. Ron Hubbard, the inspiration behind this podcast and the religion I respect very much. Just, Scientology. Start your own. So let's work. Okay. So just real quick, off the fly, what do you got? Elevator pitch. I'm in a position I can give you your own religion / political party.
Mm-hmm.
What are the tenets of it?
Sexual freedom.
How free?
Anything, anyone, anytime, anywhere. We're all a bunch of animals. Let's do this.
Total freedom.
Total freedom.
I can think of at least a few things I could throw in there. But I'm not going to. No,
do it.
I'm yes anding.
Go ahead. Go on.
What about the age of consent?
That's definitely going to be there. Come on. Okay. We're not breaking any laws.
Okay. Oh.
You can't break any laws in other religions. What the fuck are you talking about? Jesus Christ. In other countries, you can.
Monogamy, Mormons.
That's not against the law.
It is.
What?
Yeah. It's illegal.
To be married to a bunch of different people.
Yeah.
That's.
Polygamy.
Polygamy is not illegal.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
No. Monogamy is not illegal either.
No, well, I mean, it should be, right, fellas?
That was part of the problem. it's bigamy, right?
No.
When you're married to a couple people at the same time?
Oh, wait.
Or polygamy? Is that it? Fuck, dude.
That's bulimia.
Bulimia? Bulimia. When you're married to a bunch of people, it makes you sick.
Okay, so sexual freedom. What else do we got?
A bigot is a race, so bigamy. I feel like that's it.
It's when you do something you're proud of is big of me too.
Yeah. So sexual freedom.
Freedom.
You can be married. You can have a bunch of wives or a bunch of husbands, whatever the fuck you want.
That's very woke, by the way. No whore shaming.
No whore shaming. There's no whores. There's no whores allowed.
No.
Because they don't exist.
Yeah. Because we're all
only no whores allowed. Only one whore. what else? It would be. Tax-free, pay into it as you want.
Tithes only?
No tithes.
Where are you getting your money? No money.
Hey, y'all want a pool? Pitch in for it, homie. Y'all don't want a pool? We don't get a pool.
I got to tell you, I think you're doing it wrong.
I'm tired of meeting up in this parking lot. Anybody want to throw in
on
the spot?
So
no
far,
pressure, though.
Pretty good religion.
No pressure, because I'll meet up in a fucking parking lot. I don't care.
But you made it a rule that they're never allowed to give you. They can give you money if they want to.
We can all pitch in on something. Okay. I'm pitching in too.
Oh, I see. The slow sell.
You know what I'm saying? Gotcha.
Okay.
I'm not trying to live off them.
Buddy.
I know that's a scam.
I think you're missing. Okay.
I know that's
it's a missed opportunity, I think.
Man, it just sounds like I just want some friends, huh?
Yeah. It sounds like. Is it too late to join a frat?
Yeah.
They only have them in college?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
That's a missed opportunity there. No. All right, so we need one more tenet of this of George.
I'm super bad at this, dude.
George's.
I have no idea.
Guns.
No.
Mandatory.
Mandatory guns.
Mandatory guns.
Mandatory stun guns. I don't fucking know, dude. I don't really give a fuck. I don't like hanging around people.
Oh, that's good. That's it.
Yeah.
That's it. No. Forced interactions.
No forced interactions.
You are allowed to. I'm going to rebrand it for you.
Okay, thank you. Help me out with this.
You are allowed to not go to stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Totally okay. Nobody's allowed to shame you.
Mm-hmm.
You are canceling plans left and right.
I got it.
Okay.
You get up and mm-hmm. you can be as negative as you fucking want.
Okay.
Like it's reverse anger management. Let's do this. Get it out.
Oh, nice.
And you go up there and you could just be blasphemous. You could say, fuck this and fuck you. I hate everybody. Bunch of fucking cunts. And you out of breath.
Oh.
And people are like, Yes, that's the word of the day. And it goes up, and I go, thank you, everybody, for coming out. We're going to do this again tomorrow. It's like the airing of the
grievances.
Sissy fight club. Like, no one actually. It's like verbal the argument. Abuse. Yeah, it's just verbal abuse.
Nice.
The hymns, you know what I'm saying?
That's great.
Yeah.
I would do that religion.
Just straight up, yeah, abuse. Verbal abuse.
To just getting it out.
Just getting it out, you know?
Draining the poison.
That way you're driving, you don't get the fucking urge to cut somebody out, you know, shit like that.
Yeah.
Whatnot.
Yeah.
There is a gun range. I would love a gun range. We all go out, shoot some guns, get that off our fucking chest.
Yeah.
And
I like it.
And I think, yeah, actually, I'm digging this now. Yeah.
It's good. You just got to make your own lane. There's not a lane. You're not seeing yourself represented here.
I'm not. No, yeah.
It's representation crazy. Matters.
Yeah.
Remember whenever Precious came out? What happened then?
That was fucked up.
Yeah, well, the fat people also stopped losing weight. They were like, okay, well, we don't have to.
That's crazy, bro. Yeah. That is insane. I celebrate everybody, but at some point, it's like, Lizzo, you're fucking unhealthy, dude. Stop.
Yeah. But also, yes,
I'm worried about her. I wanted her to keep going. I wanted to have longevity in her career. I don't want her to fucking die of a fucking stroke or diabetes or none of that. I want her to lose, some weight. She has good fucking music, and I'm glad she celebrates her fucking body. She's not ashamed of it.
Yeah.
But hit that fucking treadmill or something, bro. I love your music.
This is, come so we could, I've got it. We could, Lizzo, if you're, and I know you are listening to this. Mm-hmm. You have to start, and it's like in the military, we have to say sir at the first and the beginning of it. So we have to say yes, queen, number one.
Yes, queen.
So yes, queen, Lizzo, you got to put it down.
Mm-hmm.
You can't. There can't be cake every day.
No.
Put it down. What the fuck are you doing? Yes, queen. So you gotta put couch it.
Yes, queen.
Uh-huh.
Try the plant-based for a couple of months. It's gonna suck. You'll feel better. Get the energy. Yes, queen.
Yes, Lizzo. Yes, queen. It's a bad look. People are not respecting you because you don't present yourself like you have any self control of yourself.
Yeah.
Yes, queen.
Lizzo, yes, queen. I love you. I love your music. I want years to come of this music. I don't want you to be cut short because of something you could have controlled, like blood pressure and fucking diabetes and all the other like comorbidities that come with being morbidly obese. Yes, queen.
Yes, queen. Lizzo. Yes, queen. Get it together. Yes, queen. For fuck's sake. Lizzo, you're important to us.
To the culture, to the movement. Yes, queen.
Yeah. Yes, queen. Yeah, so we're going to start there. You're not represented here.
No.
You're only, you're opting out of the political movement. That's what you're doing.
Yeah.
I'm not playing your games.
I can't. It's impossible.
Yeah. So good for you.
Life isn't black and white. It's not right or wrong. It's not.
That was a callback, folks.
If everybody's right, who's wrong? Everybody's right, bro. Who the fuck can be wrong?
That's good. You just got to find the place in the world where you're right. Are you a guy who has a problem with beating your family? I got a place for you.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
But are you a guy that thinks about beating your family? I got a place for you, too.
Dude. You just got to find your own. I think, the country you're born in is one thing, but, you can find. I'd love to be a soccer hooligan.
Yeah, really.
I think I'd love that.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I should pursue it.
Like Green Street.
Yep.
Hmm.
Minus the violence. Mostly really? The songs.
Just the songs.
Yeah.
The songs, yeah.
We got bear songs. Dude, they're fucking good.
Manchester.
United.
And drunk and they're fucking and someone bust a glass and it's fucking over.
Oh, everybody. I think, lads, just hanging with the lads. I'd love that.
Hanging with me mates.
lads. Yeah,
with me mates.
Beer.
There's G.I. Joe of what they do, and then you're like the generic beer.
Oh,
You're the army guy.
Dude, I'm like the play school. Like, what was the?
You got the weird fucking fatigue pants that come off the guy. Oh, they're not like painted on like the G.I. Joes. I drank beer. Like,
beer.
Okay, buddy.
Mate of mine, other day. You don't go down there, do you?
Dude, I keep checking my watch. Listen, I think you're going to be okay. I think you're strong. Don't do anything crazy.
Yeah.
I know you're going to be here alone coming up pretty soon. You know, you can always call me. I might not answer.
You son of a bitch.
But I'll get back to you as soon as I can.
I keep checking my watch. Look at what? I mean, we haven't even started the show yet.
Listen.
What have you got to do?
You're fucking fun, good-looking, sexy bear. And the women that love bears.
Strong bear.
They're plentiful, dude.
I'm a bear.
You're a bear.
Dude. I'm a bear.
Cuddly.
I'm putting it out there.
Winter man.
I am a winter fellow.
Yeah.
Bad time for me. I'm still saying.
Not at all. Not at all. Not at all. Because DJ Khaled lives in Miami, homie. So there's never a bad time for bears.
Yeah.
Never a bad time.
I think that's great. That's great branding. I can say it loud. I can say it proud.
Yeah.
I am a bear.
Yeah.
I hope that's not, it doesn't have any other meanings to it.
The type of girl that just wants to cuddle on the couch. Oh, dude. Those are the ones you want anyway, dude.
Real question is, do I want that?
Yeah, of course. Why not?
What are we watching?
Something that she's happy. Something that makes you happy because it makes her happy.
Whoa.
She doesn't care.
I think that was the problem.
That was the problem.
Whole time, you were solving my problems. You know what? Thanks, buddy. I appreciate you. And I would like to say this. I want to play the voicemail here, and I'm gonna contemplate. I'm going to think. Okay, here we go. This is the voicemail this week. And again, very serious, so we're going to use reverence, okay?
If you're in Spain or you're in Italy, they roll the like
the R's.
Yeah, they go Ratteria, Ratteria, Ratteria. And these people are all assholes. I don't know if you've ever been to Spain or Italy. the people there are assholes. They're contemptible assholes. And I think that has to do with language. I think that's because the flourishy language. If you say you want to get in a car, if I want to go downstairs, I have to go downstairs, I have to open the door, I have to lock the door, I have to get in a car. And to say that, I go, I'd probably start having insane fucking thoughts. If that's the shit that's going through my head every day, I'm thinking, I have to go to the refrigerator and get myself a drink.
Was
and I'm
going, Cook?
You'd probably turn into a fucking freak if that's what your inner monologue sounds like. What does French sound like?
I don't fucking know.
I have to close the door and then I have to empty out the trash, bring it to the dumpster. Fucking idiots.
All right, I don't think those are the views of anybody here, but he has a point. So take that with you. All right, let's do this. Let's get some plugs out there.
I'm out here talking loud in the city. I'm out in the city, and they could hear me. Look at this.
Where can people hear you talking loud in the city, my friend?
You can go to Wolf of Ignorance podcast. It's on YouTube. Go to fmcwstudios.com and you can see a whole slew of what we got going on. Josh is the mastermind, mad scientist. I just show up, I lay it down, you know what I'm saying? I lay the pipe.
Yep.
Raw.
Good shit.
Leave.
Nice.
And Josh creates the baby. Fucking, you know what I mean?
Nice, dude.
And podcast, check out the album, georgeanthonycomedy.com. The album's Murder and Mayhem. It came out last year. I'm gonna record another one this year, another half hour this year. So I'm doing half hours because I just feel like who the fuck wants to listen to somebody for an hour?
Facts.
No one has an hour drive anymore, you know?
Oh,
I figure,
wow.
Hey, you want to get from here to work? put me on for half an hour. That's about, and coming home, if you're 15 minutes away from, you know what I'm saying? Just put me on again. Boom.
That's reasonable.
Done. And you're done with
that's
it.
That's reasonable.
You're done with it.
It's good. And the re-listenable, it's very, you can re-listen to it.
Can
I've
you?
Done that. Yeah.
Thank you.
It's the only thing I have. Well, I have you and Raul's albums. That's the only ones.
Oh, no shit.
I have. That's it. But yeah, I fuck
nice.
With it.
Nice,
yeah.
Man. I appreciate that. I'm pretty proud of it. It came out a year ago, you know.
Very good.
I scrambled to fucking put it together just because I wanted to do something while people were trapped at the house.
Yeah, it was so like the way that you opened that album. I'm not gonna say too much about it. The way you opened
it, it's been out for a fucking year.
The way you opened that album says everything that people need to know about you.
No shit. Yeah really. Yeah.
That's Balls of Steel number one.
Oh yeah, dude.
And that's straight up, bro. I mean, yeah. It's great. Go get it.
Big fucking. I wasn't even planning to do that. I was just like. After I talked to that one guy, which was so unnecessary,
yeah,
I was like, "Fuck it, I'll just fuck him with this one," and I fucked him really good for about a good 10 minutes.
So good.
And at the end, they wanted me to let's keep this going. I was like, "Nah, I'm gonna talk about OJ," but
oh yeah,
it was. I thought, man, that's my favorite joke. That's my favorite joke
yeah.
so far.
It's amazing. Yeah. So yeah, also just follow George. If you buy the album, if you don't like it, I'll pay you your money back.
Whoa,
how about that?
Pay me as much. You know, buy it,
yeah.
Buy it, bro.
Buy it, and there will be a quiz. I'll make sure you did listen to it.
Nice,
but
okay.
No scams.
Yeah. Nice. Yeah. At GA Comic on the social media stuff. Yep. And man, I fucking love this podcast, bro. My episode that I went before, fucking, you carried the whole thing. Yeah, I thought I sucked balls on it, dude. I think I was a little too inebriated.
Really? Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, and I couldn't get into it, or maybe I was into it. I was somewhere else. I don't know why I did that. I think
really?
I was a little nervous because my episode was gonna suck, and it did. I thought it sucked
did not.
I thought
suck.
It sucked balls, dude. Compared to other episodes I heard, I'm like, damn, man, I'm the weakest link, homie.
Oh, you're so.
So
wrong.
Hopefully you can cut this one up pretty good. You know?
Nope.
Which
all
I think
unedited.
Which I think was part of the problem, dude.
Oh,
I think,
yeah.
Yeah, so hopefully this is at least half of what you normally do, bro, because I'm a huge fan.
Oh,
I'm not fucking
buddy.
With you, dude.
I know, you're the first one.
I listened to it in the car. I listened to yours, Raul's. I listened to Blair's and Bobby's.
Yeah.
I listened to other people that we know, you know, some awesome podcasts and shit. And yeah, I'm digging this whole fucking Texas thing. Hopefully we rise above
the
trash right now.
Yes,
because there's a lot of trash
that
came from other places.
Yeah.
I'm not saying everybody's trash, but a lot of them is trash.
A lot of them is very trash. And we should get the okay, yeah. So we need to rise up.
And the only way we can rise up is together, you know?
Yep.
On standing on each other's shoulders and shit. I think there's a good thing going on, you know? Minus Zahid. I don't think he's gonna make it at all.
No, fucking stinks. No, yeah.
He's super fucking like mystery guy. No one knows where he is or where he's from.
Yeah.
You know, like,
he's from Africa.
He's from that's what he says, bro. Like,
yeah.
That guy says he wears a queen. I'm from Queens.
Yeah.
I talked to him. He's like, yo, well, I was born and raised in Queens, but I'm in Houston. And
Queens,
I mean, depends
Queens
on who
what?
You talk to, bro. Depends on who you talk to is where he's from, bro.
Queens what? Shady. Queens Africa?
Dude, Queens. Yeah, exactly, dude. He's super shady, bro.
But he knows about Bitcoin. Oh, wait, that is shady. Also, shout out to GameStop. Shout out to me for having diamond hands. I want to say that. So I did diss you last week. Love you again. Let's go to the moon.
So, where is this going, bro? Like, what do you plan to do with this shit?
This will be on YouTube. This one's
going
on YouTube.
I mean, bigger picture type shit.
Like
there's networks you can get attached. I don't know if that's your thing.
They're gonna have to talk to me. I want to own my IP. That's very important.
Okay.
As long as I can do that, then yeah.
Yeah.
I'd like a manager. Somebody manage me.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody tell me what to do. Focus mm-hmm. my energy.
Have you talked to Cliff?
No. What's he going to do?
I don't know. Cliff makes magic happen, bro. Cliff is into all kinds of weird shit, all kinds of cool shit.
Black Israelites.
Yeah. He's trying to find fans wherever he can.
I'd love to. I mean, to be the first black Israelite to spike.
have you ever been to, have you seen that shit?
Oh, yeah, dude. The Louis Theroux documentary?
Hilarious. No, I mean, like in life. They have these black Israelites that hang out in downtown Austin. And I'm walking.
They have them in Austin?
Yeah, bro. and liberal, you know, I'm walking down 7th Street and that's like Skid Row, homeless people everywhere, yeah. right? Like 6th Street's all the drunk idiots, and then 7th Street is where they end up in life, right? So I'm walking yeah. down up to go do a show at this fucking place, and around the corner, the whites are the devils and pieces of shit, motherfuckers, and you piece of shit. And the guy's like, oh, what's up with me? Fuck you, white motherfucker. And I'm walking, I'm like, damn. Which is crazy because the KKK could never do that shit, you know, downtown. Oh, no, yeah, I'm not yeah. saying they're, you know, whatever, but free speech is definitely biased in some ways, you know. And it used to be the other way, now it's the other way. It's crazy. Anyway.
What a wasted opportunity to be in Austin. Because they're all just agreeing. They're like, I know.
Oh, yeah, dude. Yeah. It's
like, I already know it's bad.
Come, yeah, dude, go to Florida or some shit. Like, fucking, that won't happen. Yeah. Or to Dallas or fucking, actually, not even Dallas. Go to Tyler.
Oh, my God. Do not.
You know, go to Odessa. I mean, I don't fucking know where the white people hang out. But, man, it's good. Anyway, I hope this thing becomes on a bigger platform.
Thanks, dude.
I hope the Boot Scoot Saloon really puts money behind this joint.
And that we can, I mean, it was the first one. It was rough. Right?
Get off of OnlyFans only, because that's fucking weird. And put this on a Patreon. Yeah. Make separate content that you can't share. Do that Patreon thing. I love the website. You got the website.
Yeah.
I love the
merch.
I fucking love the merch, bro.
This is good.
The Utah shit?
Yeah.
Killed it, homie. I want a hat. I want a shirt. I want it all, dude.
What do you think about this one, the Ass Pro Shop?
I fucking love that shit. Of course I wouldn't wear it. Are you fucking crazy? But I love the fact that I could do that, though. That's fucking dope. Yeah, I would wear a shirt like that, maybe over, you know, with a jacket over it.
Yeah, for if you're around children.
Yeah. But if I'm hanging out with the friend, yeah, for the look like I'm Zach, bro. It would be fucking dope, dude. It would be fucking dope. I think you're on the right track. I think you got to get some more steam, maybe more marketing behind this thing. I fucking love it. I'm telling you, you got the voice, you got the attitude. Don't let this, you know, what's going on right now stifle you. Propel yourself, push yourself into it more to keep your mind off what your heart's going through.
I can't believe I'm high-fiving that, but.
Seriously.
Thanks, buddy. That was great. I can't believe that's on wax. If you think I'm not going to sleep and waking up to that, you're out of your mind. I'm going to play that back in my bedroom all the time.
I hope so.
So thanks, buddy. I appreciate you.
I appreciate you.
First repeat guest, George Anthony.
No shit.
Yep.
Wow. Okay.
Yep.
I want to come back on again and again and again and again and again and again.
That would be good. I want to do a debate series, which we'll talk about.
With who? Me and you?
No, just strangers. Yeah, me and you, but versus strangers. That would be fucking dope. Yeah, I'll talk to you about it.
Okay.
I got a judge wig. Anyway, thank you guys. Patrick Stone behind the camera. I love you. Big kiss.
Hey baby, I hear the blues are calling. Toss salads and scrambled eggs. And maybe I seem a bit confused. Yeah, maybe, but I got you pegged. I don't know what to do with those tossed salads and scrambled eggs. They're calling again. Scrambled eggs all over my face. What is a boy to do?
Now let me see if I understand you. The problem I see you say.